Hey guys, today we are going to learn about tightly coupled slash closely coupled and loosely coupled systems. So this is the architecture of a 8086 closely coupled configuration. I want to tell you that this closely coupled configuration is known as tightly coupled configuration also. Now looking at the architecture, you might be assuming that it is a very hard architecture to learn, but now I will tell you an easy way to learn this 8086 closely coupled configuration architecture. So as you can see, I have divided the 8086 closely coupled configuration into 7 parts. So the first part is 8086, the second part is 8089, the third component is 8259R, the fourth component is 8288, the fifth component is 8286, the sixth component is 8282, and the seventh component is channel select logic. Now, before drawing the architecture, you have to remember that the tightly coupled configuration have these 7 components. Now these 7 components have pins which are described below. So now these are the pins of the components which you have to learn. Like the first is 8086, so it has 10 pins. Now you have to learn these pins before drawing the architecture. So the first pin is CLK, the second pin is ready, the third pin is reset, the fourth pin is INTR, the fifth pin is RQ bar slash GTO bar, sixth pin is MN slash MX bar, the seventh pin is S2 minus S0 bar, the eighth pin is BHE bar, the ninth pin is A16 to A19, and the tenth pin is AD0 to AD15. Now the second component is our 8089. Now it have 4 pins. The first pin is RQ bar slash GTO bar, the second pin is INT, the third pin is CA, and the fourth pin is SEL. Now our third component is 8259IR. The first pin is INT, the second pin is SP slash EN bar. Now our fourth component is 8288. It has 5 pins. So the first pin is CLK, the second pin is S2 minus S0 bar, the third pin is DN, the fourth pin is DT slash R bar, and the fifth pin is ALE. Now our fifth component is 8286. Its first pin is OE bar, the second pin is D0 to D15, and our sixth component is 8282. Sorry, it is not 8288. It is 8282. 8282. And now it have 2 pins, OE bar and STB. And now our 7th component, I have not written the 7th component as it does not have many pins. So the 7th component is channel select logic. Now I will show you the architecture. So this is the architecture that I have drawn. So as you can see, I have first drawn the 8086. Now these are the pins that I told you to learn. So the pins are in ascending order or in a line wise order. So this is the first component. As you can see, this is the second component, this is the third component, and this is the fourth component, this is the fifth component, and this is the sixth component, and this is the seventh component. So I have told you all the pins of this microprocessor, and of this microprocessor also, of this component also, of this component, of this component, and of this component also. Now the last part comes of the joining. So where are the lines? So we, as you can see, that the reset pin is joined with this pin, the ready pin is joined with this portion, and the CLK is joined with this portion, and it is also joined with the CLK of this component. Mn slash Mx bar is grounded. S2 minus S0 bar is in joint with the S2 minus S0 bar of this component. And the INTR of this is connected with this INT. And the SP slash EN bar is connected with the NAND gate. And the DEN is also connected with the NAND gate, and it is connected to the OE bar. The channel select logic is connected with the CA. SEL is connected with the A0 pin. And as things get more complicated, a BHE is connected to this part also, and it is connected with the third point of this component. And A16 to A19 is connected with the second point of this component. And AD0 to AD15 is connected to DT slash R bar, and it is also connected. I have drawn this, so this is the connection I have made with the third point of this component. And ALE is connected with the STV line, and the channel select logic have an IOWC connection, and here I have not drawn. It is A0 to A15. So these and the three pins that I have drawn, it is coming from the clock generator. So this is the 8086 tightly closely coupled configuration architecture, and I have shown you the easiest way to learn this architecture.